I've been asked to build and review one of the models made by U-Gears. This is produced in the Ukraine, laser cut parts. And one of the first things that I noticed before I ever opened the box was how finely detailed all these cuts were. And this is a millimeter rule, and if you look at one of these cuts, it's about the same width as one of the marks on the ruler. Open the box, and we slide this out. Everything in the kit is shrunk wrapped together, and the instructions are inside the shrink wrap. So there's no chance of losing any of the parts while this is being shipped. And there's a little compartment that holds the toothpicks that are used as hinges and axles for the kit. There's 101 pieces for this mechanical flower. I'm going to look at a couple of these. There's some very small areas that have not been cut. Very small. One up here at the top, one at this point. And you can see these are just about ready to come out of here. I'm going to go around, take my time. I'm going to cut each one of these with a number 11 X-Acto blade so that they come out of there clean. If we look at this, there's a little area here and here, and a few places that have just barely been left uncut. So those should come out of there quite easily. And you can see if you flex the wood, it opens up. The instruction manual is printed in 9 languages, so they really didn't have time to waste a lot of words. They've done most all the instruction using these symbols. And they'll tell you when to use wax or sand, a part smooth, where to cut it. This one, simply pay attention. This tells you that there's an additional part. This is another cutting, and this tells you to push it together hard. As you go through the manual, each of the parts on the plywood are clearly numbered, and when you're in a certain section of the manual, it clearly tells you what part they're referring to. Most laser cuts are somewhat tapered, and these are numbered. I would maintain that orientation as top, as seen here, like these toothpicks are coming in from the bottom and being pushed until they're sticking out on the other side, and they tell you to cut the toothpick in half first, then wax it before forcing it through this hole. And that's a very tight hole, so some force will be required. When you get to one of the other parts, like this outside ring, when you look at that on the plywood, these are the numbers, this is the top, and you'll see U-Gears is cut upside down or backwards. That means you need to turn that part over so that you can read U-Gears as it would normally be written. And they say right here, pay attention. And that's like that throughout this whole book. This book is very well done, it's very clear. Be a good idea to read all of this and go through it a couple of times before you start assembly. When you're putting gears together, there are timing marks, and these timing marks are very important, and that's clearly indicated here. Pay attention, and all these red lines are supposed to line up as you put this together. A lot of these assemblies are surrounded by a cutout. I would say you should press that out first, and then it's easy to flex this piece of wood and get these gears to release. These are only held in a couple of places. This one ring that came out, you can see where it was being retained in the plywood. After I punched that out, I just smoothed off those areas, and that's very easy to do. They show cutting these toothpicks in half. I'm going to wax them first. It's a lot easier to handle that way. And I'm just using a bar of paraffin. I snap that. Smooth off that toothpick a little bit. I'll poke it in from the back side. And then push down squarely and firmly until that goes all the way in flush. It's a very tight fit, but it will go in there. They show in the illustration, you put this tool over a toothpick, and that will tell you how thick that toothpick needs to be. And I just take a sharp number 11, cutting away from myself. I score that toothpick, and you just snap it off. A piece of sandpaper or an emery board would be good. You just want to remove that burr. When you put the gear on there, that's flush with that surface and turns very freely. I've talked about how laser makes a tapered cut. And if I put my gears together and leave them right side up, then the edge of the gear will tend to come in contact because of the taper. If I alternate the direction of the gears, right side up, upside down, then those gears will come closer together. And that's the situation with this ring gear. When I punched these out of the original sheet of plywood, I took my pencil and I just put a little dot on here. And that just reminds me which side of the gear is on top. Or the sun gear, I turned it over. And my pencil mark is actually here on the bottom side. I've lined up my timing marks through here. And the ring gear is turned over, so U-gears reads correctly. By turning this piece upside down and the ring gear and leaving all of these right side up, I've alternated that taper on the gears. And that one is in there wrong. I've lined up my timing marks, and this hole is on the inside. When I turn that, they will all come to the outside at the same time. And that's what's going to make those pedals open and close on this. And this turns very smoothly, and I have not put any wax on the gears yet. When you're trying to remove these parts from the plywood sheet, again, this is a tapered cut. If I try to bring this up, there's a chance of that taper getting tighter. So it may be easier to remove the parts by getting them to go downward than the taper is releasing. These are fairly small cuts on this. These two pieces have some pretty small areas in here, especially this one's cut with these spring-looking bits. And when you go pushing this in and out of the original plywood sheet, you go flexing that too much, you could cause something here to crack. Look for the areas that are still connected. That's going to tend to be right here on the outside edges, and it won't be all of them. There were three here and three here. I just nip the veneer with that sharp blade on both sides, work it back and forth, and push out here where it's strong. And don't flex this too much. You don't want to crack that. And the same way with this piece. I just put a little pencil mark here to remind me which side was facing upward originally. The quality of the plywood is very good. It's even color, even grain pattern. You don't see any blemishes on either side of this plywood. Somebody in the Ukraine is paying attention and doing quality control work. These two pieces have been replaced, and you can tell that by the difference in the grain structure and the difference in color. Either the laser did something wrong or there was a blemish in the wood. They punched those two out and replaced them with good quality parts. That's a very good indication of quality in a product. The instructions show put it together and then wax it. we don't want any wax on this piece. It's going to be a press fit, and it's going to be tight. Line that up. Push it in there as far as you can by hand. Make sure your teeth are on a hard surface, even and square, so you don't want to break your teeth. And that one hasn't gone down. Now it's all the way down. All of these parts have been waxed as I'm putting them together. The rack teeth have been waxed. I put a little wax on the bottom surface because that'll be sliding back and forth. And that pin goes right into that slot. Installing the stems for the pedal or pedal supports or whatever you want to call it. These two pillow blocks go into these slots, and what I was calling springs before are just that. They're pushing against this pillow block and making it rub on this part here. I've waxed the inside surface of these two and both sides of this and the gear. One's on one side and one's on the other. When you get down to this last one, it's getting a little crowded in here, so you just need to be careful. You take this, you put it in here, and kind of squeeze on these and slide that down in there. And you come in with a toothpick. Then I take something like this piece of plywood. I put my fingers on this side to support the pillow block over here and push on that toothpick. Push on it squarely so that'll go in there. I score that toothpick with a sharp knife. Reach in here with a pair of pliers and just snap that off. Little sandpaper. These all move pretty stiff. It's not that they move stiff so much as the springs are putting pressure against the stem and acting as a brake. When you get to this stage, you need a little patience and a whole bunch of persistence. These arms have to be down, and these pieces have this little notch on the bottom, and that's a very snug fit going through those holes. So you need to get all six of those to line up, and you need the straight rack part that's down here on top of the gear with the pin. Make sure that pin is still engaged. You need to make sure that all six of the timing marks are lined up with everything. And you use this tool to reach in here and nudge things around back and forth until you get this rack to come up in between the bottom part of these pillow blocks is actually where they're coming up in there. And make sure that everything pushes down solid. And all the time you're doing this, this ring gear is trying to jump out of there because you don't have a whole lot to hold onto down here on the bottom. When things get away from you, set it back down on a hard surface. Make sure all those timing marks are lined up and nudge these things down until those are at least flush down here. And then pick it up. Make sure these racks are in between these slots. And just gently start working things around until these come all the way down to this position. The next part is to take one of these and slip it underneath there and push it down in this hole. And that locks everything in position. Trying to get this piece aligned with 12 pins. You just got to keep wiggling things around until you get them started. It'll take a while. Smaller hands or smaller fingers would not be wasted on this. But this all interlocks together. this is not going to fall apart. Then, grab the outside of this ring gear and gently start wiggling it back and forth and get those things to moving. And you can just keep turning this around and around, and that will open and close. Just be careful you don't snap one of these off while you're trying to get this thing to free up. Hopefully you've put enough wax on that to get things going. Now it's just a matter of putting the rest of these pieces of the pedals on. It starts getting a little crowded in here when you start putting the rest of these pedal segments on here. And I did manage to break two of these. I broke one off here and the same flower on this piece. And that's a very small cross section. Not only is it a small cross section, but it's also got a slot cut down the center of it. You need to be very careful with these. When you get ready to push that in there, take the tool and put it across that segment. Put your finger behind the stem and push square on that. They did provide one extra piece for each of these positions. I don't intend to use that. I'm going to put these little pieces back on with some epoxy. There's one extra piece for the legs of the base and a whole bunch of extra toothpicks. There's no shortage of toothpicks at all. It's interesting how precisely this goes together. This is a very well made, well engineered little gadget. It was a fun project. This will keep opening and closing. You can just continuously turn it one way or the other. A little ballerina dances around on the inside. Or you have the option, instead of the ballerina, to put this little tree in here that will hold rings or small bracelet. Nice gift for your wife or your girlfriend or your daughter. If you're interested in one of these, please go to the website link that's in the description for this video, and it will help support this channel, not only for the purchase of this item, but for any of the UGear products through the link in the description.